Good morning, students. Today we have practical physiology of spirometry. What is spirometry? It is a simple and safe test that measures lung volumes with a graphical display. Gives an estimation of lung function. Allows for diagnosis of airflow obstruction. Permits good follow-up for asthma and chronic obstructive pulmonary. Spirometry in practice, a technique used to measure airflow in and out of the lungs. Recording of lung volumes and capacities defined by the respiratory process. These recordings may be static or dynamic. Dynamic means it is related with timed. Static means untimed. Assess the integrated mechanical functions of the lungs, chest wall and respiratory muscles. The gold standard for diagnosis and assessment and monitoring of COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, better than peak expiratory flow rate, which is effort dependent for demonstrating airway obstruction, the most commonly used pulmonary function. Airflow obstruction to help make the definite diagnosis of COPD and also detect the airflow obstruction smokers. And to assess one aspect of response to therapy and perform pre-operative assessment to distinguish between the obstruction and restriction of the lung. Perform pre-employment screening in certain handheld spirometer. This is handheld spirometer. Spirometer in the 50s, long back this is, and nowadays we are using this spirometer. The operator is, the name of the operator is spirometer or vitalometer or student spirometer. Here we have a recording drum is there and also mouthpiece. Oxygen chamber is there. Other is the floating drum. Two cylinders are there. Outer cylinder, inner cylinder. Inner cylinder is made up of light weighted metal. In between we are keeping water. So here the mouthpiece is connected to the vitalometer. Whenever the person after taking deep inspiration, he expires the air through the mouth tube so that this floating drum will be connected with a indicator as well as recording drum. It will record on the drum according to the efficacy of the person, inspiration or expiratory effort. So vital capacity we are estimating with the help of vital. You can see this type of instrument. Many types are available nowadays. What do we measure with a spirometer? With a spirometer, we can able to measure the vital capacity. Vital capacity is nothing but it is the sum of tidal volume, inspiratory reserve volume, expiratory reserve volume. So lung volumes and capacities. As you know, here we have tidal volume, inspiratory reserve volume, expiratory reserve volume, residual volume. This here we have tidal volume 500 ml, inspiratory reserve volume, and this one is the expiratory reserve volume, and we have all together we have vital capacity. Vital capacity, this much is the vital capacity. spread reserve volume, tidal volume, spread reserve volume. And tidal volume with the inspirator reserve volume, inspirator capacity, tidal volume with the expirator volume, functional residual capacity. Total length capacity will be reserve volume is about tidal volume, the amount of air that can be inspired, we call it as inspired reserve volume. And expired reserve volume means that can be expelled, about tidal volume, we call it as expired reserve volume. The amount of air that can be remaining in the lungs, we call it a residual volume. And inspiratory capacity and functional residual capacity. Expired reserve volume plus tidal volume, we call it as functional residual capacity. Inspiratory reserve volume plus tidal volume, we call it as inspiratory capacity. And inspired reserve volume, tidal volume, expired reserve volume, call it as vital capacity. The amount of air that can be expelled after taking breath in deep inspiration. Total lung capacity will be 6 liters. Theory already, you know all the things. Maximum breathing capacity. This is normal one. This is abnormal. Forced vital capacity, forced expiratory volume. Forced vital capacity. Forced vital capacity. This is the total amount of air that you blow out in one breath. We call it as forced vital capacity. Forced expiratory volume in 1 second. This is the amount of air you can blow out within 1 second. With normal lungs and airways, you can normally blow out most of the air from your lungs within 1 second. We call it a forced V1. Normally the forced expiratory volume will be like this, and COPD they cannot able to expel forcefully that much. Here we see almost 5 liters. Here only 3 liters in COPD, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease. Here also we see 80% will be normal, 60% will be in COPD. Forced expiratory volume in 1 second will be 4,150, 4.15. Obstructed lung, restricted lung. Here we see all the volumes and capacities will be changed. Spirometry allows for detection of airflow obstruction, for diagnosis, COPD and follow-up. Obstruction is present, the test person is given bronchodilator. This is bronchodilator.